For anyone out there that says this is going soft on drinking and driving, what do you say?
We are eliminating anyone who has caused injury or death. We are definitely taking it serious, but also giving people a chance at life. Ironically, 31 years ago today, my father was killed by a drunk driver.
Signed into law Monday by Governor Whitmer, a bill spearheaded by State Rep. Tanisha Yancey from Wayne County allows for a clean slate for non-repeat OWI offenders. It's estimated 200,000 people are in that position and can now seek expungement 5 years after probation ends.
You shouldn't be punished again for the rest of your life because of a mistake that you made, let's say in college or in your early 20s.
Defense attorney Jeffrey McCarty applauds the move, which would still be ultimately determined by a judge and excludes operating while intoxicated incidents causing death or serious injury. He also points out drinking and driving on your record impacts much more than just a job application.
This day and age, your criminal history affects financing, it affects your credit, it affects housing.
There was actually 16 of us that voted no on it. I've been a bail bondsman for many years, over 30 years. And I see a lot of people that do bad things when they're drinking and driving.
An opponent of the law, State Rep. Matt Maddock of Milford, makes the argument people busted drinking behind the wheel have typically done it many times before being caught. As a result of House Bills 4219 and 4220, the law applies to anyone caught with a blood alcohol level of 0.08 or more. A Facebook page, viewers also weighing in, one writing, "If they have learned a lesson and prove they're able to not drink and drive, I get it." Another saying, "It takes one DUI to put themselves and people at risk."
Just have very little tolerance for people who drink and drive, and I'm pretty positive that this is going to get around and people will realize that they get free first pass and your first drunk driving, so that's why I voted no. It's not just drinking and driving. You know, we're talking about people under the influence of drugs. There's a lot of people out there driving around taking painkillers and all kinds of bad stuff.
The new law also applies to anyone under 21 caught with a BAC of 0.02 or more. Part of the governor's legislation will also ensure our state's legal alcohol limit remains at 0.08. We've also reached out to Mothers Against Drunk Driving for a response to this new law, and so far, we are waiting to hear back. From Southfield, Simon Shaquette, 7 Action News.